close to my 50th question, around 51st, 52nd, I was not getting answer for a lot of them in a row. I was not getting any answer. So I was like, abhi to kuch hone wala nahi hai. Let me look for November or let me study later. But as I continued, I was able to get few answers correct. Then I continued and finished the paper. So thing is, if you're not getting answer for few questions in the middle or even at the beginning, don't stop. You should fight till the last questions. You never know the result. Hi, I'm Dr. Hema. I'm from Shumoga Institute of Medical Sciences, Shumoga. I have got NIMHANS DM Neurology rank 8 and PGI All India rank 27 and OBC rank 3 and JIPMA rank 67. I have finished internship in March 2018. Then I started my preparation only after internship. I had not planned anything before. So initially I was attending classes. So then I was using Marrow Plan B, only question bank and test series. So I had good concepts and facts and I was revising, but after few days and few months I was like, I was missing on few concepts. So then I wanted some classes, some video classes to reinforce them. So then I subscribed for Marrow C. Initially I had Plan B. So then I also took videos so that my concepts become stronger. That is what when I changed my plan. So speaking about Marrow videos, yeah, first of all I would like to thank Dr. Rebecca ma'am, because I like all her biochemistry videos, the way she teaches with lot of concepts and lot of examples, and especially these topics of storage disorders, glycogen storage disorder, lysosomal storage disorders, and inborn errors of metabolism. She teaches with lot of clinical cases, examples, treatment. So then we can remember the theory part of it, the enzyme deficient, what is the treatment, what are the clinical features. So, and also genetics part of it, because PJ asks a lot of genetics. So the way she teaches it, DNA, RNA, the structure. So that was very helpful. So that sometimes if you miss, because it has a lot of chemistry also, a lot of core theory also. So you need to revise them and understand them, many of them, because at one go we might not be able to keep everything. So I like her videos. And physiology, I like all Krishna Kumar sir's videos, especially his neurophysiology and nephrophysiology I like. And I also like his jokes, like when he starts class he'll be like, do I look familiar to you, the same Krishna Kumar? So yeah, I like all his videos. And speaking about pathology videos, Ila ma'am's lot of image based videos, I like her, the way she teaches a lot of stains and images, pathology image based discussion and general pathology, all she gives a lot of tables so that you need not search for them and you have them at one place. Systemic pathology, lot of important topics, her videos are crisp and clear, and they are at the same time they are very important. Lot of questions, especially from breast pathology, thyroid and hepatobiliary pathology, the way she has given lot of points, they're all conceptual and crisp. Yeah, those videos I liked. And talking about microbiology, I like Shivika ma'am's especially lot of fungus and parasite videos I have watched, because AIIMS ask lot of fungus and parasite about. And in general, microbiology is very important as such, because PJ also ask lot of microbiology questions. And pharmacology, Ranjathan's pharmacology videos, general pharmacology videos, immunomodulators, chemotherapeutic agents, they initially have general pharmacology has lot of concepts, but they're very important because they get asked in every exam, be it NEET, AIIMS, JIPMA, PGI, the questions get asked there. So we need to have a strong base for general pharmacology. And then speaking about medicine, I have really no words to describe Dr. Rakesh's videos. Dr. Rakesh sir has explained, he starts with anatomy, goes to physiology, comes to pharma, path, everything, and at the end of the class he integrates everything. Though sometimes they look lengthier, sometimes we feel the same topics are repeated in, they are also there in pathology, they are also there in pharmacology, but it's okay because it gets added and it stays for long. So that is how he integrates. So even if they look lengthier, it's okay because at the end of the day they help us only. So he's especially the questions on rheumatology, immunology, hematology and nephrology. He's covered lot of important points which get asked as questions in lot of exams, because gone are the days when questions used to get asked about only the classical cases, like classical case of malaria, classical case of typhoid, tuberculosis in India. But now there are lot of atypical presentation and questions are also get asked in that way. So we need to have an integrated concept of it. So see, if earlier is like Sjogren syndrome, it affects glands, salivary glands and lacrimal glands, but its association, how does it affect kidney, how does it affect lung, how does it affect other organs. So such questions get asked now. So that is how Rakesh sir's videos help. He integrates everything, he integrates the whole the system, what are the systems involved, and he integrates treatment also, pathophysiology also, everything. So that is how medicine videos are very important. So if you watch his medicine videos, half of your pharma, pathology, physiology and anatomy is also done, because he touches upon them also. And one more important subject for any exam is OBGY, obstetrics. Sakshi ma'am's obstetrics lot, I think I have watched all of them, because she also teaches very conceptually, and the point she gives and the note she gives is very crisp and clear. And surgery, Rohan sir's surgery classes are, they look smaller initially, yes, they look like 30 minutes, 40 minutes classes, but they have got the complete important topics and concepts in them. So speaking about the way I used videos of Marrow, actually I'm not a good, I don't make lot of notes, I'm very lazy about it, so I don't make lot of notes, but I watch lot of videos, because writing notes, listening to teachers is more helpful for me than writing notes. So I have watched many of videos, actually medicine, pathology, pharmacology and biochemistry, I have rewatched many of them. So it's the speed, you can keep them at your comfort. See, I used to watch 2x many of them. Sometimes medicine, somewhere I was not able to understand initially for the first, when I was watching for the first time. So I used to reduce it for 1 or 1.5x. So later, second, when I was watching it for the second time or third time, then I would increase it for 2x. And then speaking about Marrow Q Bank has got some important questions on important topics and important questions in the subtopic also. So it's better you solve your question bank not immediately after watching videos or immediately after revising your notes, because anyway it's there in your notes, and you also, you get it done here and you score some 90% and you feel, I think I'm scoring, or I think I'm in the correct path. But that is not the way to solve it, because if anybody can solve them after watching video or notes. So ideally what I was doing is I used to solve them randomly whenever I was fixing some time, because from 8 to 10 in the night or 9 to 10, 1 hour or 2 hours, then I used to solve the Q bank of important topics, like for example hepatobiliary system, I would solve viral hepatitis question bank, because that's very important questions get asked there, hepatitis A, B, C, important questions. So I have not solved many of the question bank, but make sure you solve them. If you have good time of 8 to 9 months, you can solve them. Otherwise, if you have some 4 to 5 months, you have started late, or if you are intern working, if you are a doctor working in CHC, PHC and preparing along with that, then you can solve important questions, but make sure you have solved all the important questions. And speaking about marrow pearls, pearls are really pearls because the way they have kept the name, I think so, because they have got all concepts, the like they are differentiating between Caudine syndrome and Conus medullary syndrome, differentiating between cholera poisoning and arsenic poisoning. So lot of like you get them in the same page and you can differentiate microbiology, what is the disease curve, what is the bacteria, what is their type of motility and bacteria and parasite, what are the eggs, bile stain, non bile stain. So you need not really go to your notes again because pearls have them all. So pearls you can solve whenever you get. I used to watch pearls or read pearls when I was getting bored, like night during late night, some 10 pearls, or early in the morning when you really don't know which subject to start with. So I used to start with some pearls, and yeah, that is how I used pearls. If you're traveling or if you're working and getting some time in between, you can watch pearls, but make sure you read at least important pearls, because you can bookmark them also and prepare. Speaking about marrow notes, yes, the notes are attached to the videos also. So if you have watched videos once, you have got your concepts are important, and so are the facts, because facts also get asked a lot. Because you can't just rely on concepts and go to any exam. You need to many of them. You need to understand first and then later by heart and revise for 2 to 3 times. So fact, if you have watched video once, then go to notes, because you need to study facts also. So then if you're somewhere, if you're not getting 1 or 2 concepts, you can come back to them, because there in notes also they have written some, what is the time. So you can directly go to that particular moment in videos and look if you want. Otherwise notes attached, so you can read there also. So see, if you are traveling or if you are somewhere where you can't take your notes, so you just have your mobile or tablet, whatever you have, and you can read notes also. So in that way you can conserve your time also. Then speaking about the grand test and subject wise test and lot of mini test, numbers test, common, like most common test, whatever, like take every test. I was like, though I was not prepared initially, I used to give every test as and when it comes live. So just give, so that you get to know where do you stand also and how much to improve also. Because initially when you start your preparation in the second month, third month, fourth month, of course if you are starting after internship like me, of course you can't expect great ranks, because there are so many things to learn. And even if you have studied once, you can't get ranks, because it requires a lot of revision. So don't hesitate to take tests, and don't get demotivated by looking at the ranks. It's fine if you're getting in some thousands, that's okay. Keep giving tests as and when it comes live, so that you can analyze also. And just see, after giving tests, just see what are the questions you have got wrong and what all you have got right. Sometimes if you guess, you don't know. So if you have guessed and got right, you don't know. So just see the whole questions and give importance to questions which you have got wrong and note them, add them to your notes, so that you can revise them. And also you'll get to know what are all the important topics, because GTs are made out of important questions only. So that is how you should give your tests. I also want to thank Marrow's support team, because I have asked them a lot of queries. I have mailed them for topics. I have mailed them for queries regarding videos, and they were very helpful, and they also clear your queries early in time. They don't take a lot of time. I have called Marrow's support team a lot of times. So yeah, they're also integral part of my preparation, so I also want to thank them too. Yeah, speaking about preparation, so I started after finishing my internship. So people who haven't started, please start, because it's very important to start early. So people who are studying in second year, third year, final year, people who are in their internship, you can watch Marrow videos and make notes, because you have a lot of time, and they also help in your university exams and your Viva also. So please start. And people who are starting after internship, no need to dishearten, because you might sometimes feel people in internship already ahead of you because they have finished so many subjects and revisions and you are starting now. It's okay because better late than never. So start seriously. If you have 6 to 8 months or some 10 to 12 months of time, whichever the exam you are planning for, if you are planning for one. Otherwise, if you are generally planning to give AIIMS, PGI, JIPMER, NEET, that's fine. So please start and don't get disheartened because you are ignorant or you thought you can prepare after internship. It's fine. It's totally fine. So just prepare. Just start preparation and don't stop your preparation until you get it. Because what happens, because everybody doesn't have the luxury of being at home, luxury of having your loved ones, people who support you, your parents, family around you. Sometimes you need to shift to cities to study with your friends or to attend classes. Then you also have problem of staying away from home. You need to shift to paying guests, hostels, then some rented house. That all is fine because you might not have a big table to put all your books and study. You might not have your parents to pick you up whenever you feel low or depressed. You might not have your mother to bring you the coffee or breakfast, whatever, and with the exact amount of decoction you need. They're always there. They're all there wishing you the good and praying for you. So just keep doing your part. It's okay. People who have started initially, people who have luxury of being at home and preparing, good. You continue and do your preparation. People shifting to cities and preparing, that's also fine. Just have faith in yourself. Just believe in the process. Initially, you might end up thinking कहाँ आके फंस गई, but that's fine because everyone feels so, because the rank one also feels so. It's fine. Just trust the process. Just keep revising. Just enjoy being in that position, because sometimes being vulnerable is also fine, because at the end anyway you are gonna get the results, and of course it the process ends and it should end happily. Yeah, that is why you should strive for, you should work for. So just keep working. Never think too much about the results. Never think too much about the ranks you get in GTs. Sometimes what happens, your seniors get, your classmates get, your juniors get ranks, and they get into good colleges, and they are quite, you might feel they're ahead of you, but it's okay, because getting into AIIMS, PGI, JIPMER or MAMC, any college for that matter, is not equal to success. It's part of journey, and success is not destination, it's journey in itself. So never get disheartened or demotivated by any of this. Of course, it ends in a good way. Yeah, you should make it happen. You should ensure that it ends in a good way. Yeah, speaking about the strategy of preparing for exams, I think there is no different strategy or there is no different agenda. Every exam, the topics, the questions, the facts, the concepts, they remain the same. The core concepts, they remain the same. You need to be strong in them. Yeah, there is no difference, but there are minor differences, like PGI as immunology and biochemistry a little bit, and a little bit more, and AIIMS as biostatistics, vaccination, and few topics differ that you can study, that you can master whenever you have it, one week or 2 weeks exam for that. So otherwise the pattern is same. I have not prepared differently for any different exam. Yeah, the base remains the same. You need to be strong with all your facts, not only concepts, facts are also important. And one more thing which is very important is, don't read anything which you can't revise, because if you can't revise, then it's waste. So don't even think of reading anything which you can't revise. Only if you can revise, just read them. If you can revise 2 to 3 times, because that's very important. I want to thank my parents. Both of them are farmers, but they were always supportive. When I thought of not attending NEET counseling and told them I want to wait for another 4 to 5 months to appear in mid-year Central Institute exams, they were really supportive. They never asked, I think you could have taken this, that, anything. They were like, do whatever you want, because at the end of the day, at the end of the hour, it's your life. And I also have an elder sister who is very supportive. She is teacher and puts all her earnings on me. So, and I also have an younger sister who with whom I stayed and prepared. And whenever I was feeling low or depressed, she used to say, just work. The more you work, the luckier you become. So you have your support system. They're always there. So just do your part. Don't think about other things, that this friends, family, they're always there. They're always wishing you the best. Just do your part consistently. Just do your part persistently. So then it will be paid off. Yeah. Thank you.